name is Schultz, and this lesson is designed for AP Calculus AB. It's on differentiation on both. This specific video is going to be on the quotient rule. And I teach at Boston Collegiate Charter School, and my website is offonatangent.weebly.com. Here's the quotient rule is like the product rule in that you break it up into the product rule, you break it up as the first factor and the second factor. But the quotient rule, you break it up into the numerator and the denominator, you find the derivative of each. But the derivative of a function that's a quotient is not just, it's not just take the derivative at the top and put it on top, and take the derivative at the bottom and put it on the bottom. We learned why from the product rule, we saw that in action, that what might feel intuitive, like that just take the derivative of each and divide them by each other at the end, doesn't work. We're not going to go through that here, but there's a whole formula, and so let's learn that formula. That formula, we're going to learn it verbally first. So we're going to call the numerator high and the denominator low, and I'll use hi when I write it for high and lo for low. So the derivative is the formula for the derivative of a quotient. You start with f of x equals high over low, f prime of x equals low d high minus high d low over low squared. So I'm going to say it again, and then you're going to repeat with me at home. Low d high minus high d low over low squared. All right, so the derivative of a quotient is low d high minus high d low over low squared. Again, low d high minus high d low over low squared. So let's see an example in action. So let's take the derivative of this. That's a numerator, that's a denominator. So first I'm going to set it up with my low and my d low. So and my high and my d high, like that. So this is kind of like my u and my v and my du and my dv of the product rule. With the quotient rule, I'm going to use low and high. I like to start with low because low is the first thing that starts in the formula. So low is my denominator, x squared plus 3, high, 2x cubed plus 5x. So d low, we're going to use that, the power rule. So 2 comes out in front, 2x, derivative constant 0, so plus 0. This would be 3 times 2, 6x squared, this will go to 5x. 5, so that's plus 5. So now let's put it into my formula. So I know my answer is going to be a quotient, so I start by drawing my big quotient. So low d high, so kind of like the product rule, I am crossing, I'm going to make these crisscrosses too. So low x squared plus 3, low d high, 6x squared plus 5, minus high d low. This is why lower is important here, since the subtraction sign, x squared plus 2x squared plus 5x, high d low, 2x, over low squared, x squared plus 3 squared. And that's my answer, but are we going to have to simplify it? Yes. Notice how, before we move on, if you compare the original to the final, clearly the numerator is completely different. But the original denominator, when you use the quotient rule, it just has the same denominator, only it's squared. It has the original denominator just squared. So let's foil this out. If you want to take a minute and pause, do it on your own, and then check up here to see if you foiled correctly, you can, or you can just go along with me. All right, so 6x to the fourth, that's 5, that's 18, so that's 23x squared plus 15 minus. And this is very important. So this does not need to be in parentheses, strictly speaking. But this, when I distribute out by the 2x, it does, and here's why. So 4x cubed plus 10x squared, all right? It's very important that these parentheses are here. Or you can use brackets, whatever. But it's very important they're here, because I'm going to have to distribute out this negative, all right? So we'll see that in the next step. The denominator, you never have to do out, all right? It's just, you want to leave it in factored form. It's nice and simple looking that way, and then just nothing's ever going to cancel with it. So you just don't, typically you do always have to do out the denominator and make it bigger before it becomes more condensed and simplified, but the denominator reduces. You have to do out the numerator. So 6x to the 4th plus 23x squared plus 15 minus 4x cubed minus 10x squared. So notice how this turns into a minus is important. You would only get that if you remember to put your parentheses. So 6x to the 4th minus 4x cubed plus 13x squared plus 15 over x squared. So I do think this does look simpler than that. That's why this is our preferred answer. And that's the derivative of that function. Okay. So let's do another example based with polynomials. So given this function, q of x equals 7x minus 4 over 5 minus x squared. So go ahead, set up your low. Low, D low, high, D high. Set that up, pause the video in a sec. So set this up and do the whole quotient rule, low, D high, minus high, D low over low squared, and simplify the numerator, get your final answer, and then come back and join us. So go ahead and pause the video. I'm gonna do it out. All right, so I'm doing it out just in case you need to see it. 5 minus x squared, negative 2x. Make sure this is a negative 2x, it's easy to forget. So low, d high, minus high, d low, over low squared. I'm going to notice that both of those make a positive, so I'm going to multiply everything out together. Oops, doing correctly. 14x squared. That's right. Okay. This should be a minus, actually. I made a mistake. And then I'm going to combine like terms, so 7x squared minus 8x plus 35 over 5 minus x squared. Even if you this top were factorable and you were to factor it, it would not end up canceling. Alright, so that's a polynomial example. Hopefully you did it successfully on your own. If not, maybe you made a sign error or something like that, or an error. I feel like most of the time with these, it's about having very clear, structured, organized work. And you're probably not going to, if you mess up, you're probably not going to mess up on the calculus end of it, hopefully. More often, you'll mess up on the algebraic part of it. So just really have clear notes, work. All right, let's do this example together. I think this is the last example I'll do. Oh no, this is the second class example we'll do together on this video. Then there's more problems left to go in the next video. So when you look at this, this is a product and a quotient, or you could rewrite this and make it not as a quotient. But we're going to embrace the quotient rule here. So anyway, I don't want to have to do the quotient rule within the product rule. It's possible to do that, but do you see a way to rewrite this? So we don't have to use the product rule. Yeah, you multiply out that x squared. So x to the fourth. So you multiply that, so that becomes x to the fourth minus 2x to the fourth over x plus 1. Right? So now that we have this, just as an aside, you could, a lot of times with the quotient rule, if you do want to avoid it, in many cases you can. So you could always rewrite this as that, just this part of it. 2x to the fourth times x plus 1 to the negative 1. And you can use the quotient rule instead of the product rule instead of quotient rule. So this 2x to the fourth term would be your u, and this term would be your v. Then you'd find du dv and do u du udv plus vdu for the product rule. But we're going to embrace the quotient rule because it's good. And it's really, it's you don't have to rewrite it. It can be more efficient. All right, so f prime of x equals the derivative of x to the fourth, or x cubed, minus. And then I'm going to do this in my head, actually. You can always write out your low, d low, high, d high, and do it out with the crisscrosses. I encourage if you want to do that, you always can. Sometimes you can use mental math. So I'm doing low, d high, derivative that d high, minus high, d low, all over low squared. So again, low d high minus high d low over low squared. And you can always write that out as low with the low d low and high d high there if you need. So take a second, pause the video, and do that out, because again, a lot of the mistakes happen in the algebra and the arithmetic, and then come back and join me when you've gotten it. All right, so hopefully you're back joining me. I'm doing it out now. And you can leave your final answer like that. So take a minute, check this with your answer you have on your paper. All right, let's do this last example, the quotient rule graphically. Right. So I have this unseen function called h of t. Problem tells me that h of t equals f of t over g of t, as shown below. So this is the function f of t, this piecewise function there, piecewise linear. And then this piecewise linear function is h of t. So I'm asked to determine h prime of 3. So maybe we'll be able to apply, like we did a similar problem with this for the product rule. Pause the video, see if you can find this. All right, hopefully you tried it on your own. Let's go through it together. So low equals g of t, d low equals g prime of t. I'm going to leave a lot of space here, actually. High equals f of t, d high equals f prime of t. So now I could do the quotient rule right here, but I like plugging in, substituting in the 3 for my variables now, and then so when I do the quotient rule, I'm just doing it with numbers. For me, it feels like it saves time. So g of 3 is, we'll figure out what they all are in a minute. So it's g prime of 3, this would be f of 3, this is f prime of 3. So g of 3, I'm just looking at the y value, so the y value is 3, incidentally. G prime of 3, so the question is, how do I find g prime from a graph? You ask yourself, what does the derivative represent? Derivative really represents the slope of a graph. So the slope here at 3 is 0. So that's 0. If you didn't get to find these two, take a second and find these two on your own first. F of 3, this is the slope of exactly negative 1/2, so that'd be 0.5 or 1/2. F prime of 3 is the slope here, oh, we just found slope, so it's negative 1/2. So slope is negative 1/2. So now when I do low, d high, 3 times negative 1/2 is negative, so I'm going to write h prime of 3 equals 3 times negative 1/2 minus, minus 1, low d high minus high d low, minus 1/2 times 0, 1/2 times 0, that's 0, over low squared. So low is 3 squared. Then I'm going to simplify that, negative 3 over 2 divided by 9, it's the same as multiplying by 1/9, right? Becomes 3 equals negative 1/6. My final answer, that's what h prime of 3 looks like, is. All right, thanks very much. This is Michelle's, and continue on to the next video on quotient rule, and then we're also going to do some higher order derivatives.